The kernel and range of a linear transformation are subspaces. Subspaces are vector spaces, which means that they have a basis and also a dimension. The dimension of the kernel range of a linear transformation have gotten their own name. You will learn what these names are and how they can be computed in this video. So, if you have a transformation T from a vector space V to a vector space W, T linear, then you know that the kernel of T is a subspace and the dimension of the kernel of T is called the nullity of T. And similarly for the range of T, it's also a subspace. So there's a basis and a dimension, and the dimension of the range of T is called the rank of the transformation T. So let's do some examples. But if you have a matrix transformation, so T goes from Rn to Rm, T of x equals A times x, where A is an m times n matrix, then the kernel of T was the null space of the matrix A. So the nullity of T, which is a number, is the dimension of the null space of A. And you can find it, of course, by looking at the number of free variables of A. And then the range of T, we found that that was the column space of A. So the rank of T is the dimension of the column space of A. And sometimes this dimension of column space of A is also called the rank of A. So the rank of the transformation T is the same as the rank of the matrix A, and which is, of course, if you want to compute it, the number of pivots of the matrix A. And then, second example, if we have a transformation from P3 to P2, where we compute the derivative, well, what's the kernel? The kernel of T is a set of all polynomials which are mapped to zero, so those are all the constant polynomials, so the kernel is a span of one. So the dimension of this subspace is just one, of one factor in the basis. So the nullity of T equals one. And what about the range of T? Well, you can reach all factors in P2. So your range equals your codomain in this case. P2 has as dimension three, so the rank of T equals three. And then, third example, finally, if you have T from P1 to R, which you get by integrating your polynomial from 0 to 1, we found in an earlier example the kernel and the range. The kernel of T was the span of minus 1 half plus T, so the span of one polynomial. So the dimension of the kernel equals 1, so the nullity of T equals 1. And the range, well, we could reach any number in R, so the range of T equals R. Which has dimension 1, of course, so the rank of T equals 1. And then you see in those examples something special happening already. If you add those numbers 1 plus 1 equals 2, which is the dimension of the domain. And if you add here 3 plus 1 equals 4, which is the dimension of the domain. If you add here number of pivots and number of free variables, then you get the number of columns of the matrix, n, which is the dimension of the domain. Would it be a coincidence? Or would this always be true? I leave that question for now open for discussion.